If you've seen my review of the Xiaomi Mi Notebook 13, this is the 2017 model, you would have seen that I could not install the latest NVIDIA graphics driver. Well, they've been onto it, they've released an update now, and in the change log, it says it now supports installation of the newest drivers on this right here. So it's the MX150 with 2 GB of dedicated RAM, and it is basically the same as the 1030. Now the new driver is installed here, as you can see, which is now 385.28. So I've got that in there running. I'm going to have a quick look at what kind of difference it makes and then follow up on a few requests I've had. People have asked me if I can overclock the GPU and undervolt the CPU, which I will do later on. So at the moment, the CPU, you can see here, is at the stock voltage. I'll change that soon. So I'm going to run Tomb Raider here. So this is the benchmark I've been using to gauge the performance. It's just easy for me here. So I'll run it first and we'll see if the driver improves anything. And then we'll have a look at doing a little bit of overclocking on the GPU. So just to show you that the settings are the same as before. It's the lowest preset, 720p. Run that benchmark now. And see the kind of results we get from the driver update. There's a result, so nothing has really changed. 58 frames per second is the score that I got on the older driver. So the drivers has not really given us any boost there whatsoever. Now that's fine. So what I'm gonna try now is to just do a little bit of overclocking on the GPU. I'm gonna undervolt also the CPU. So to do that, I'm using Intel Extreme Tuning Utility. And I've set here the core voltage offset. For me, on my system, this is a stable undervolt. Now if you go any higher, it will just give me a blue screen. Now that's going to vary from CPU to CPU, so if you're going to be testing this out on your model, just keep going up in increments of 0.005, really is what I recommend. Test it, do some stress tests in here as well that you have built into the Extreme Tuning Utility. Now you can also increase the turbo power limits. That I wouldn't touch that actually, because that's not the aim here. The aim here of undervolting is just to try and lower the temperatures a little. Maybe it'll turbo up a little bit higher. Now the overclock on the GPU here, I have discovered that putting more clock on the GPU core is really pointless because it's never going to get up to that boost speed. So if I pull up the information here, you can have a look on system information. So the maximum boost speed it will go up to, while here it is 936, but it never gets up to that because it just doesn't have the thermal headroom to do this. So it's pointless to add any clock to it. But what I've discovered that the memory clock, this is going to seem crazy, I can put a whole whopping gigabyte more of speed on there, and that is perfectly stable. So it seems that what NVIDIA have done, or probably Xiaomi, has they've underclocked the RAM there a little bit. So having that bonus here, let's now run that test again and see what kind of results we get, keeping an eye too on the thermals. So it has given us a little bit of a boost there. I can see already 96 frames per second. This is just the start of the benchmark, but I'll skip ahead now to the results. So the GPU RAM overclock has given us approximately 5 frames per second average boost there, which isn't too bad. That's not a bad gain there. So I will actually try putting a little bit of higher clocks on the core clock here of the GPU. So I'm going to tweak this up now. I've just put 50, even though it's probably not going to allow me to do this. I'll manually just key that in, 50 megahertz more on the clock. And we'll see what happens. For some reason that's not sitting. There we go. Okay. So that's given a tiny little boost more. You can see it's just gone up a frame or two more. So it's not bad, but let's have a look and see if I can even push that further. Now I was thinking that the GPU clock was completely pointless tweaking that, but I'll try this as high as 70 because the thermals are actually still quite good. We're not getting too hot on there so far that I can see. The maximum GPU temperature has been 70 degrees here, which is fine. So I will try plus 75. Hopefully it's not going to lock up on me. Now, if you see any artifacts or things like that, then you know that you're overclocking too much and you really need to tweak back those speeds that you're putting on here. Of course, you do all of this at your own risk. So there we go, that actually lowered the scores a little. So boosting that GPU clock really isn't that beneficial at all, but you can get a little bit, as you've seen, from tweaking up the RAM there. So now to have a look at thermals. I do have HW info running in the background here. No, I don't. That has closed itself off for some reason, but I can check here. You can see that the CPU package temperature, maximum temperature is 75 degrees. So that is perfectly fine. And now if I go back and have a look in MSI Afterburner, the maximum GPU temperature is 72 degrees. So those temperatures are perfectly fine. Where it does get hot, of course, like I pointed out in my gaming review and my full review of this laptop, is just here, just above the vents, that gets up to, actually, yeah, there we go, 47, almost 48 degrees. So very toasty to the touch there. It's almost getting up to, it feels like it's going to burn you kind of material there. So that's why I always recommend with this laptop, if you are going to be gaming for extended periods, get yourself a laptop cooler. That's probably going to help out a lot too with just improving performance maybe. But I won't actually be testing that myself because I really do not like laptop coolers. I like portability and a machine that I can just pack up and put in a bag and not have to lug around an extra accessory for it. So there you go. You can see that the drivers made absolutely no difference in performance, but we can do a little bit of undervolting and overclocking there of the GPU to boost things up around, what is that, about 8 or 10% performance, which isn't too bad considering that's free performance there that we're getting. And I've run that for a couple of days now with zero problems. I haven't noticed any artifacts from the memory. So it seems to handle that extra 1000 megahertz on the memory clock perfectly fine. Thanks a lot for watching this video. And if you haven't already, check out my full review of this model. Bye for now.